Would you like to crop so the subject's head is center? Or face? Or eyes? I made a script to do it. Crop, center, head. I'll show the script in Windows. It works the same on Mac OS. Before I show the script, I'm going to change the background color. You'll see why in a bit. To run the script, open the Actions panel. I already have an action to run the script. For help adding scripts to Photoshop, see the link in the description for another video that shows the steps. In the Actions panel, select the script, Crop, Center, Head. Click the Actions panel, Play button. Start with what to process, the active image or a folder. When nothing is open, active image is disabled, so the only choice is folder. Check the option Include Subfolders if desired. Click the button Folder and navigate to the location of images to crop. In the section Options, set the target size. Values are pixels. Enter margins top and bottom, also in pixels. These values can be negative. I'll show that later in the video. Next is how to center the image left to right. Choices are eyes, face, head, or subject. Subject looks at the result of Photoshop's Select Subject feature and centers the subject found. The others look for the feature and center the image based on it. I'll show the difference later in the video. Center offset adjusts the center point. Negative pixels moves center to left. Positive moves it right. When the image is less than crop, there are two choices, both optional. You may use one or neither, but not both. The first choice is content-aware fill. The second is to scale the image to fit. This alters the margins, but no more than needed to reach the desired size without creating additional image. There are also options to log when an image is less than crop and save the result in a subfolder. Then images less than crop are separated from others so they may be inspected. In the section Output, click the button Folder and choose where cropped images are saved. Select the file format. Choices are BMP, JPEG, PNG, PSD, or TIFF. Each format has specific options which should be familiar. The last option is Original File Name Plus. This adds a suffix to the output file name, or leave it blank for none. To start, I'll center head and do nothing when images are less than crop. Click OK and the script gets to work. Let's have a look in Bridge. Here's why I changed the background color. It helps make clear where images come up short, and the background color is added. Back in Photoshop, run the script again. This time use content-aware fill and enable the log and subfolder options. This time, a log is produced. Click Yes to open it. The log describes the remedy for the one image less than crop. And the image was saved in the subfolder Review. I'll open the image and have a look. The bit of missing image was created, and it matches well. Now let's compare the centering options. Here is center subject and head. Subject, head. Now compared to face. Head, face, head. And compared to eyes. Head, eyes, head. As you can see, the difference can be subtle or drastic, depending on the subject features and pose. And here is the result of entering a center offset. Center head minus 100 pixels. Center head plus 100 pixels. Center minus plus. Now let's try negative margins. Make the top margin minus 600 and center subject. The result is a waist down crop to feature pants, for example. Or the opposite. I'll do bottom margin minus 900 and center head. The result is a top crop. You get the idea. Get the script at the link in the description. Like this video and subscribe. Also, leave a comment. All feedback is welcome. Click the video or playlist on screen for more. Thank you for watching.